And now, Myles, our chart of the day.
Great animation. So I think a topic that's come up a lot in the market that frankly is not really the warning sign that some think is the underperformance of small caps. We know that they've been lagging really all year. Small caps are still more than 10% below their record high that they hit in the fall last year, along with the broader market. And I think a lot of people have said, oh, well, you know, the market can't go anywhere if small caps aren't going to get on board. Actually, that's not really true. That's not really what history shows. Now, over time, small caps do outperform. It's one of these quirks in the market. You know, small caps have a higher risk premium. Investors are rewarded over the long term for them. And it is, academics debate why this actually is. Mm-hmm. But the underperformance that we've seen in the Russell, which has not really caught up with the big guys, you look at what's happened in just the last month or so, you see the Dow, we're using the People's Index here, really pulling away from the Russell. And I think people say, well, they're going to have to come together. The Dow can either catch down to the Russell, or the Russell can catch up. And I think, DataTrek a couple of weeks ago kind of looked at this and said, not really. Go back to the late 90s. The S&P outperformed the Russell significantly during, I think it was 1997. Market was up 30%. Russell was up like half of that. Eventually, the Russell caught up. Guess what happened? Blow off top crash after the tech bubble. And so I think it's just another one of these instances where intuitively you would say there's no way that this can persist, right? What are the small caps seeing that the big guys aren't seeing? However, market history says that for large periods of time, there is a divergence and it's not necessarily bad for the market.
Is there any sense that if you go back and look historically for when this shift happened, that it is a symptom of something that's happening in the capital markets mm-hmm. and the economy that we would see this, these two pull away from each other?
No, I mean, I think, you look at this chart, the answer is no, right? Usually over time, they have about the same fortunes. But I do think that what we're seeing in this kind of moment, and Sozzi, I'd be interested to hear your thoughts here, is just that, big cap companies are able to defend themselves either with the tax code or with shifting their supply chain in a way that small caps can't right now.
I'm still, call me old school, but I still view this underperformance, not only in the small caps, but also in the semiconductors for obvious reasons, as a problem. I still view it as this market move in the small caps is suggesting something in the first quarter of 2020. That's just how I read things. I look at a lot of U.S. companies, you see growth slowing down. Growth could take a next leg down. If we just had JP Morgan's chief economist on a couple days ago, he's looking for 1.25% growth this quarter, and that might hit 1% in the third quarter, and that's a big red flag.
And another thing that, in terms of defending themselves, they don't do as much or as on a bigger scale as buybacks.
Yep, not yet.
Brian Sozzi, thanks so much. Have a great weekend.
Have a great weekend.